went into the woods prepared to find death. What they found was a desecration of humanity at the site which trappers have often referred to as Coffin Rock. On top of the rock formation, the story of the torture inflicted upon these brave five men unfolded. Each was bound to the other, each man's hands bound to the next man's feet, forming a solid structure out of the men. Blood at the edges of the hemp indicate that this act had been committed while each was alive and able-bodied enough to struggle. In the torso of each man, the intestines had been torn out crudely. On each man's sun-bleached face was inscribed in decipherable writing, cut into their flesh with an eerie precision. The men, still entranced by the horror of what had happened, left the scene to find the sheriff, and did not sketch the writing and did not remove the bodies from the rock. Upon return, vultures were seen at the rock. But upon inspection, the bodies had been removed by persons unknown. The search party claims that the stench of death was still thick, and whomever had taken the bodies had done so in a matter of hours. That happened here, at Coffin Rock.
I don't know about you, but that introduction just takes me out of the game. It's like shoving in your face the fact that, hey, this is a hard story about something that happened a long time ago, and you are just staring your comfy modern day whatever. I mean, wouldn't it be great if, say, something like Baldur's Gate started with opening a book, which... opening a book in the modern day and just made it painfully clear that, hey, this is all just a fictional fantasy story. Nothing here is real. Welcome to Blair Witch Volume the Second, Coffin Rock. The second in three games relating to the Blair Witch thingy. I did the first game some time ago, and I thought I'd do something horror themed for the length of the entire October, and thus I decided I'd do the remaining Blair Witch games back to back, and I have to say the first one was the best. And each game is done by a different development studio. You saw this one is something called Human Head, and the third one is we'll see about that then. And as with previously with Nocturne and the first Blair Witch game, perhaps we'll only record the actual gameplay, not this menu or that intro or loading screen, so I'm using a different recording program for this bit. And we'll switch over once actual game starts. And speaking of that...
Date unknown. Dearest Anne, I fear this will be my final entry. All my men are gone, dead or missing. I no longer even know what day it is or if your eyes will ever see this journal. These woods are a maze, and I fear that whatever has been stalking us these past days will soon take me as well. Farewell, my love.
Time is not up, soldier. I have need of you yet.
Mister? Are you okay, mister?
Oh.
You don't look so good. I better take you back to Grandma's house. She'll know what to do. Come on, mister, you can make it. It ain't that far.
Follow her.
Hmm.
Go.
do we have thus far? Looks like we are a Civil War era type of soldier who's looking quite pale and is apparently hearing voices in his head. And here we have a saber. What happens if we try going the other way? There's not much else to... Oh, what's this? Okay, let's see. Yeah, these stick figures are our health item for the game. Not sure what kind of sense that makes, but okay. Loading. The owls are not what they seem. Maybe they are. But do owls seem to be anyway? Owls? Starting to wonder, does it? Actually, it doesn't show the saber handle on the sheath. I see another thing. Hey. I wanted to check out that white sparkling.
Grandma! Grandma, come quick!
Is she a...
He was out there! In the woods! Just like she said, Grandma! But he don't look so good!
Really?
Girl! What have you done this time? You! Better get you inside! Fetch me some fresh water from the well, Robin, and some rags. This man is hurt bad. Now don't you worry. The Lord has put you in my hands, and I'll take good care of you. Damn those dark woods.
Mister?
Where am I?
Shh. You rest now. I'll take care of you.
What's that demonic voices? Just watching me sleep. That's kinda creepy. Oh hey, out of body experience. So, hi. Can't do anything here. So do you have any comment about... No? Just, seeing yourself from outside your own bodies. Not worth commenting on. Okay. How can I... I guess I should follow there, but... Okay, I'll go there. Open either.
Join us
now. A cross. Yeah, let's kill some children. And save a child too, maybe. Whoops. Hello? Can I do anything about her, or should I just wander around killing those kids? Oh. I see another pair of glowing eyes. Hi there. Any more? More? Hurt me more. Oh. Let's check this way. Oh, maybe now I can do something with the girl.
She's too late. Keep away, the child is mine.
I gotta go now, mister. The lady from the woods is calling me. But my grandma will take care of you, so don't you worry.
You must hurry now. She's in great danger. Hurry! She needs you.
You know, I'm getting conflicting signals here.
Where is she?
Hush! Now don't strain yourself. You're going to be all right now. The fever is down and your wound is healing up nice enough. We were plenty worried, though. You were nearly gone when Robin brought you here.
Where am I?
This is my home, my farm, just outside Burkittsville, Maryland.
The little girl?
Oh, Robin, my granddaughter, my precious child.
I should thank her. She saved my life.
She's gone missing.
What? Where?
The woods have got her now.
She came to me in a dream. She told me she was going somewhere.
Sounds like the woods are calling you too. Just as well, because I need you to go there soon enough. First things first, though. I'm Bess Weaver. You're lucky Robin found you when she did. I helped tend to the injured during the war, and I learned a thing or two about treating a wounded man. That's a nasty shot you got across the side of your head. How did you get it?
I don't remember. I can't remember much of anything, to tell you the truth. I don't even know who I am.
No wonder, with a wound like that. Well, we'll just have to call you something, I suppose. I can't just have you wandering around like the living dead. Well, that's it. You walked out of the woods like a dead man reborn, just like that fella from the Bible. Lazarus, his name was. It fits you, at least until we can figure out your real name.
Lazarus. Good a name as any, I guess. I remember being a soldier. Men were dying all around me, and I...
Hush, hush now. You're just going to make things worse for yourself. Now you just lay back down.
No. I think I'm well enough to get up now. I never was one for lying about. At least I don't think I was. My uniform. What happened to it?
I had to burn it. It was caked with dirt and blood. But I had something for you to put on. These belong to my son, Jimmy. And I don't reckon he'll be needing them.
That's kind of you, ma'am. But why do you say your son won't be needing them?
Good Lord took him home. Been 5 years now. doctor said it was the pox, but not me. I've seen pox before. I think it was those damn woods that killed my son.
I'm sorry to hear that, ma'am. You've been good to me, taking me in and doctoring me up, but it don't feel right, wearing your boy's clothes.
You can keep the clothes. Like I said, Jimmy doesn't have any use for them now, but I'm going to ask you for something in return.
I'll do anything I can, ma'am.
Those damn woods have my Robin, my precious baby. They're going to try to take her away from me just like they took my Jimmy. I need you to get her back.
The woods? What are you talking about?
You've been out for 3 days now. Yesterday morning, while I was tending to your wounds, Robin disappeared. The girl's always been headstrong, just too damn stubborn. She said she was going to play in the woods, and I told her not to. But after I finished tending to you, she was gone. I knew where she went, and I knew something bad was happening. Those woods have always called to her, and now they've got her.
I'm sure she's okay.
No, she's not. I got the neighbor folk to send for help, and they searched the woods around the house until nightfall, but no one found a trace of her. Parson Vance put together a search party to go look for her today. But those woods are too smart for them. They'll never find her. You're the only one who can find her. You made it out of those woods. The good Lord delivered you to us to protect my baby. I just know it.
Ma'am, I can stand on my own 2 feet again, and for that I thank you. But I'm not in any shape to help anyone right now.
But you have to. Those townsfolk don't know the woods like I do. They can't fight what's out there. But you're different. You have the power to bring back my little girl. I can see it in your eyes.
Woods are just trees. If that little girl is out there, I'm sure the people of this town can find her.
You're wrong. Those people are going to their deaths. And don't ask me how, I just know it. You're the only one who can save her. I brought you back from the gates of death, Mr. Lazarus, and you're in my debt now. I need you to repay me by finding my little Robin.
All right, ma'am. Bess, I'll do what I can.
Oh, thank you. She needs you. I don't know if it'll help, but there's a pistol in the drawer of that wardrobe. Jimmy bought it brand new from the coal company back in 81, just before he died. There's some bullets in there, too. Jimmy collected guns. Never fired him much, but he did love to have them. If you'd like, you can practice out back while I make you something to eat. I imagine you're hungry after so many days without a meal.
No. Actually, I'm not. I know I should be, but I'm not.
Let me make you something anyway. You're going to need your strength. Rummage around the house if you like, and take what you need. You're welcome to whatever you find, if it'll help you find Robin.
Well, that was a blood dump and a half. Also, a man who is unnaturally pale has a grievous head injury and he's called Lazarus. Oh gee, I know. I wonder if this is all foreshadowing for a completely predictable plot twist. So, ma'am, obviously that gun was not in a drawer but on the dresser. 20 group of bullets. Okay.